Hey guys, it's Windy from Windy's Art. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to paint a realistic apple in watercolor. Painting an apple is good practice for beginners because it has simple shapes and colors, so you won't feel overwhelmed or frustrated with color mixing. Before we even start painting, let's talk about choosing the reference photo. I will recommend using reference photos that are clear and high quality. Also, let you have good lighting that will help with painting the details and shadings. The better the reference photo is, the better the painting will be. By the way, I will put my reference photo link in the description box if you are interested. Now let's start painting. I always start with a contour drawing, and I like to mark out the shades and highlighted areas, so it's easier to put on colors afterwards. After outlining my sketching, I start putting a very light wash for the base color, which is mostly water. I suggest to keep the base wash very light so we can work on layers and details later. After the base wash is completely dry, I start putting on a darker layer. So in this layer, I'm working on some of the shadows and highlights. Trying to paint out bigger areas with different shades, then we will work on the details after this. For example, the brighter parts near the tip, I use dry brush techniques to paint out the texture. If you don't know what the dry brush technique is, you can check the link in the description box. I explained the basic watercolor techniques in another video before. Also, I like to avoid the highlighted area when putting on a darker layer. You can use masking fluid instead if you preferred. When putting the darker layer, notice there are different values in the apple's color. As you can see, the bottom area has a lighter tone of red than top area. I suggest observing the reference photo and test different colors on another paper before painting. This method will also prevent you from painting on a wrong color. And the more you paint, the easier for you to find out the color you are looking for. After I put on a darker layer, I can see my highlighted area seems a bit too light, so I put some lighter shades on it. And remember, it's still a light reflection area, you want to avoid adding colors that are too dark. After I'm done painting the darker layer, it's time to add all the details. I start focusing on the bottom areas, I'm using a red and orange color mixture to strengthen it. Also on the right side, it has a green and yellow tone color. Here's a tip, you don't want to mix the green and red color because they're a complementary color which will cause muddy color. So I first put a darker layer of the green with a yellow tone color and wait until it's completely dry. Then I start putting on details with the red and orange color. Because the paper is dry, the paints you put on afterwards won't flow into each other. Then I use a white watercolor pencil to add all the small white highlights on the apple. You can see apple has all these small white dots on the skin, and I find a white watercolor pencil is great for adding these details. It's a white color but not too bright like a white gel pen. I like to paint along it again after I added the white details with watercolor pencil, so it looks smoother and more natural. Lastly, I pan out the tip of the apple and strengthen the shadow around it. And that's it, the juicy apple. So that's all for today's video. I really hope you've enjoyed it. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell so you won't miss out on my weekly art videos and tutorials. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next week. Bye!